Not everyone has the ability to see art in galleries. There's quite a collection of Native American art at the University of North Dakota. Art and design professor Art Jones knew this and wrote an award-winning book about Native American art at UND. Thanks for coming on the show today.
Well, thank you for having me, Monty.
Yeah, well, first of all, I have to address this. Your name is Art, and you love art, you work in art, you're immersed in it every day. Mm-hmm. Was this fate?
Well, I capitalize on it. You know, it's something I've always taken advantage of.
Of course. Yeah. Now, can you explain a little bit about the project you've been working on, this living museum of art?
Okay, well, when I came here in 2003, I noticed that the university had this really incredible art collection. The problem is it wasn't being utilized in very effective ways. It was used as decoration, but it wasn't used much for education. So I came up with this idea of trying to better manage the collection, and along with that, eventually through time, came up with this concept called the Living Art Museum. And that meant utilizing art in a way that related to people in the environments that they inhabited or worked in, so that, for example, in the education building, we've put works throughout the building, keeping the theme of education in mind,
sure,
which relates to the people.
So you're bringing it out there,
yes,
to buildings that weren't originally meant to display art, but they're around there, yeah, part of the building now.
Well, we don't, the university doesn't really have its own art museum. Even though there's an art museum on campus, the North Dakota Museum of Art, it's really not part of the university. But the university does, on the other hand, have this really incredible art collection.
Sure.
And it really wasn't being put to very good use.
And part of that wonderful art collection, as you were going around to the different places looking at art, was the Native American art.
Oh, yes.
And so you started seeing this around, enough of a pattern that, wow, there's a lot here, that you wrote a book about it.
Yeah, and I should say that in writing the book, I wasn't so presumptuous as to think that I could just write a book on Native North American art. I made sure that I involved a number of other people in the book project.
Sure.
So I'm a co-author.
Right.
And co-editor of this book.
Sure. And now this book, tell us exactly what it's about.
Okay. The book features works that the university owns, and also work owned by the university foundation, which is separate from the university.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, the title of the book is Storytelling Time, Native North American Art from the Collections at the University of North Dakota.
Sure.
And the reason why it says at instead of is because it also includes the university foundation collection as well as the university's own collection.
Well, how did you find the pieces to include in the book? How did you go through that?
Well, I wandered around the campus, and in wandering around the campus, I tried to locate the various artworks that existed from one unit to the other, and sometimes in academic departments and sometimes in non-academic areas as well. And in doing that, I noticed that we had scattered around the campus this incredible collection of American Indian art. And one of the most interesting places I found it was in the Indian Studies Department,
sure,
where Mary Kettling, who was at that time the administrative secretary and Lakota herself, she showed me this box of materials that she had rescued from the warehouse.
Okay.
And these were really incredible objects. There's a whole chapter in the book that deals with them and tells the story about that collection. Mary Kettling rescued it because it was about to be, thrown away.
Wow.
And
so
she brought it back to her department. She showed it to me. And of course, as soon as I told her that I had been appointed by the university administration, she thought I was there to confiscate it. So she developed an immediate distrust of me. And I had to convince her that I really was there to try to help her.
Because sure.
She wanted to sell it off for scholarships.
Right. And eventually, yeah, really show the public what a great collection this was. Now,
yes,
the design of the book includes a lot of pictures. How important was it to visually display this through the book?
Extremely important, because part of the living museum idea that I had was that we can actually contribute to the world. We can show the collection to the world through an impressive publication like this. And I should say it's very handsomely designed by a colleague who teaches graphic design in my department, Lucy Ganji.
Okay. Yeah, did a great job.
Who was also co-editor and one of the co-authors.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it is a visual. I mean, you can't get away from that. When you're looking right. through it, there's just so many great pictures in there. What can a reader expect to get out of this book?
Well, I think the reader can expect to have an understanding of how, you know, why American Indian art was collected, let's say historically, going, because we deal with that in the book too. Why did people originally in this country gather a mass collections of Native American art? And the reasons why they did it, let's say in the late 19th century and the early 20th century, are very different from the way we regard it today.
Sure.
Because at one time it was seen as, these were seen as relics from a disappearing culture.
Right.
And today we see them in much more contemporary terms as, you know, living examples
right.
of a culture that's very much alive.
Art, today. Thank you so much for coming yes. on today. It's a beautiful book, and congratulations on it.